I'm really wondering what is up with beetle larvas, so we are going to check them out, and I will also bring the ants from the hibernation. And we also have some other stuff to do. We have a couple of news. Two molts, and one of them is Psalmopoeus pulcher, that molted, and oh no, 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 don't move now. That molted, and it turned out to be a female. So I'm super excited about that. This will be first Psalmopoeus female in the Dark Den collection. She is a bit clumped up and not really that visible. She was on top, but now when I started messing up with the enclosure, she moved down, but you can see that she is freshly molted. Actually, she molted 2 days ago. I can show you her molt. You see, this is her molt. And let me try to zoom in. Maybe it will be visible on the video, I'm not sure, but I checked with the magnifying glass and I could easily see the spermatheca. It clearly flopped, so that was awesome. I still have one more sling that I didn't sex, so possibly another female, who knows. And the second molt is this one. And if you can't guess it by yourself, this is Linda. She molted today, and I also have her old molt, so we can compare it. We can go, oh no. I broke her leg, damn. My bad. This is her old molt and new molt. You see now the difference. And now she's bigger than this one. All Theraphosas got really big gains through the molt. Maybe even the biggest, I don't know. I'm not really sure, but they get visibly much, much bigger with each molt. And let me show you her. You will be able to see that she's still not hardened. She's also clumped up, so you can't really see the size now, but there she is. Freshly molted ball of feet. So now she actually outgrows this enclosure because once she spreads, it will be clearly too small for her. So we will need to make something new for her soon, really soon. And you remember these signs that I got from a subscriber? I decided to put this one, the Dark Den sign, in Sasha's enclosure, the Gramostola rosea, and he is already eager to receive it. Look at him. On the edge. So let me just blow him off. No, he doesn't really care about that. I will put this sign like here. Awesome. I think that I will put this enclosure on the table in the actual new space, so that sign will really be appropriate. Oh, now you move. All right, now with that taken care of, before we start with the beetles, I mean beetle larvas, I have some package that it is surprisingly heavy. So let's see what it's inside and from who it is. What the? Oh, sweet. Let me see, let me see. These are cookies. Cookies with chocolate spiders, as you can see. Awesome. I wonder how long they were inside. So this is from Ethan, and he's actually 5, and he baked these cookies together with his mom. And also his mom wrote this letter, but she wrote what he said. And the whole family is watching my videos together. So thank you, Ethan, for this letter and these cookies. And also thanks to your mom and dad, although I don't know how they are called. But shout out to all of you. Thanks for watching and thanks for the support. Let me try one. They are actually still good. I'm not sure how long they were traveling. Oh, and also this is the drawing from Ethan. You see, the spider. Thanks, little guy. Let's check the beetle larvas. Oh, actually, I need to change the battery. Just a second. Camera doesn't want to shut down. Beautiful. One more. Half. So the reason why I want to check these larvas, I want to see how much food they have left and if they are all right. I mean, they should be, but you never know. Ow. The reason why I removed them from... Oh, here is one. Oh yeah, it looks totally fine. The reason why I moved them here from their old box, I received a mail where someone told me that they actually need more vertical space because once they what's the word, pupate. Once they do that stuff, they do it upside down. So the person that sent me mail was concerned if they would have any problems because there was not enough vertical space in their old enclosure. So I put them all here. And from what I see, they have enough food left. Oh, there's the second one. Where's the second? They are bigger, right? Definitely looks bigger. And we also have a third here. And where's the last one? Yep, here it is, fourth. So excellent, they are all alive and fine. Let me just wash my hands. Oh, did you really? They pooped. That is totally not cool. Actually, all of them pooped. I guess it's the self-defense mechanism. They all seem to be roughly the same size. Well, actually, this one is the biggest. Can you tell? Definitely. Can you like stop pooping, please? This guy is definitely the biggest. Then these two and then this one. Well, actually, they are the same. But this is the big one, big mama. Or if males are bigger, I'm not sure. But I'm really happy that they are fine. Look at them. Beetle train. Don't bite me, please. This will be a good thumbnail picture. Oh my God, he's still pooping. Can you stop the poop? Really? I will mix this substrate because the bottom one is really soggy compared to the top part. It looks like I have been watering them a bit too much, but that's only because I was concerned because top part was drying and I wasn't sure how much humidity they have in the bottom part. But from what I can see, a lot of humidity. Off you go. I need to move all this poop first. You watch how they dig while I clean this up. Socially awkward larvas pooping all the time. Now. I need to go to the basement to pick the colonies and you're coming with me. But we can stop this and turn off this to save power. All right, let's go. Here are the colonies. The moment of truth. Are they alive? And I can already see that this colony is fine. Now, typically you would want to acclimate your colonies. You don't want to just bring them from 5 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius just like that, but gradually do that. These were in my basement and down there it's like 10 degrees maybe, probably lower when there was really cold outside. But now as the weather is getting better, the temperature down there is rising. So they also started acclimating, I hope. Now let's see them. So you see, I have them in this, how they are called. I don't know what's the English word. Women's socks. Since it was in the basement, I didn't want any other insects or other things to be able to crawl inside. So that's why I put these to prevent that. As we can see, they are pretty much alive. Although, oh my God, I will need to add new test tubes because these ones are, as you can see, completely out of the water. So that is really bad. But this one was full with water when I put them to hibernation. Was it that long? We can remove this one from Mr. Ant. So I will clean everything up and put new test tube in. But first, let's see how the other colonies are doing. I didn't say these are Lasius niger and probably this one also. This one I bought and these three I found outside. So I'm not completely 100% sure that these are Lasius niger, but it seems like they are. So one colony, other colony, also alive. But oh my God, they're all without water. I will need to fix that quick. And these got enough water. So these are the bigger ones. And it looks like all of them are alive. Well, maybe few are dead or they just need to wake up. I don't know, we will see with time. So awesome, I really wanted this colony to succeed. Let me now put this aside and let's quickly clean this colony and put another test tube inside. All right? All right. brand new test tube filled with fresh water. Let's just add this in, and I will try not to crush an ant. This was actually something that I didn't want to do, so they will probably now transfer into this test tube because there's most humidity. You see, I have this block of white tongue, and what I want to do in a future video, maybe even next video, well, really soon, that's for sure, I will drill it and I will carve it and I will make a nest for this colony and then connect it to this outworld and then try to force them to move into this nest with bright light and stuff. So that is what I plan to do really soon. I'm super happy that colonies are fine. Now I will need to make new nests for these two colonies and put these guys in their old outworld. Awesome. Everything is a-okay. Let me take another cookie. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, thumbs it up and comment something. If you want to support this channel even more, there's a Patreon page. If you're new to this channel, make sure to subscribe. I upload every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. See you guys soon. Bye-bye.